Our political reporter Marcia Kramer made no friends today on Capitol Hill with a surprise visit to try to finally get some straight answers about Anthony Weiner's Twitter scandal. What she got instead was police officers in her face. But it turns out the congressman's behavior is getting old among his colleagues, too.
House Republicans are starting to ask how a congressman could say he's not sure a picture of bulging underwear sent from his Twitter account is him or not.
I think the American people are sick of seeing their elected officials tied up in the scandals like this. I really think it's sad.
Weiner himself offered no clarity today.
Today I'm going to have to get back to work doing the job that I'm paid to do.
And my attempt to get answers got nowhere. Unless you count the threat of jail.
I'm Marcia Kramer from CBS in New York City, and I was wondering if I could see the congressman.
Weiner's staff didn't like the fact that I took the welcoming sign on his door seriously and walked in.
All I really want to know is what he wants to say to his constituents, who are the people back home who have to vote for him.
I don't know how you can say that he hasn't said anything to his constituents. He spoke for 9 hours yesterday.
But not to anybody in New York. You know, this was sort of a... I'm in the bunker in the Capitol and wouldn't talk to anybody in New York.
They called cops.
Let me see some IDs.
And they threatened me with jail.
If you're asked to leave and you refuse to leave, you can be placed under arrest.
But the question is, how will the so-called Wienergate controversy affect his political ambitions?
The only shot he has, I think, is to tell the truth, get back to being a representative of the constituents who have elected him.
It doesn't look like the so-called Wienergate scandal is going to end anytime soon. The hall outside Anthony Weiner's office was filled with reporters and cameras on an all-day stakeout, and this wasn't their first day. In Washington, I'm Marcia Kramer, CBS 2 News.
I made it very clear I did not send the picture that my Twitter account had been and this prank apparently has been successful, but after hours, almost 11 hours of answering questions, any that anyone wanted to put, today I'm going to have to get back to work doing the job that I'm paid to do. So I appreciate your patience and understanding.
Welcome back to Harvard. That was, of course, New York Congressman Anthony Weiner hoping, I guess, to have the last word about a lewd photo that he denies sending from his Twitter account. But the New York tabloids had a field day again today. The New York Daily News front page calls it Weiner's pickle. And the New York Post blares Weiner exposed. So what are the politics here for Congressman Weiner and for both parties? I think
it
is
politics.
These unilaterals. All afternoon he did Luke Russert, he did Wolf Blitzer, he did everybody one after another. He did Rachel last night. Was that a way of appearing to be exhaustive in answering questions when in fact you just decide to give it one day? So you could say you did it for 11 hours, just so you can make the case of, like the old Washington trick of output or input equals output, and although there was no output.
I think he was kind of trying to bore the press to death, but as you said, I don't think the Post and my old colleague Tom DeFrank's Daily News are going to get tired of a story about a congressman's crotch. I mean, the American people may be tired of that, as Congressman Cantor said, but I do think New York tabloid readers love it. So I think it'll go on for a while. I mean, until there's something approaching a clear explanation of what happened.
Yeah, that's the key, Chris, and Ben is right about that. He tried to exhaust us, Weiner, yesterday, but he didn't answer the questions, or he didn't answer them sufficiently. I mean, he ought to know whether those are his underpants. And there are just too many unanswered questions left to be resolved, so it doesn't matter how much time he spent yesterday on this. He's not ahead
of
the
game. I was listening to a lot of those unilateral interviews, and I never heard him deny that he'd never sent this out to anybody.
He said, I didn't send it to the woman.
Right.
Right. But he didn't say he never sent it out.
Yeah, I mean, and he also said at the end of the day, I don't know who has access to my account, which is different than saying it was hacked.
And he also was asked, do you take pictures of yourself like this? And he ducked. That's that's not one you want to duck on.
And particularly right now in his political career, he's a guy who's looking to become the next mayor of New York, and for whom the question has been, you know, is he still the kind of glib kid Anthony Weiner, or is he grown up? Is he ready for that job? And I mean, you know, if what he's saying is that he was sexting with someone else,
well,
it all does
question.
Feel like
nobody is coming to this guy's aid, Tom DeFrank.
Well, that's right.
Nobody.
They're not happy. Democrats aren't happy for a lot of reasons, one being the obvious one. It doesn't look good. But more to the point, the Democrats would love to be crowing about picking off this seat in New York 26.
Which they did in a very
safe Republican district. The Democrat, Kathy Hochul, got it. And nobody's paying any attention to that this week, and Democratic colleagues are not pleased.
I think what they're afraid of, and Steve Israel, a lot of these people must be afraid of this now, that Wiener will be the reason they don't take back the House the next couple cycles, because he will become the example, the poster child of the juvenile behavior of the Democratic Congress. Your thoughts? I think this is serious business. They could lose 10 or so seats on this, just making him into the joke. Your thoughts?
I mean, I do think Wiener was kind of auditioning for the role of the Democrat Republicans love to hate. He'll show up wherever there's a TV camera. He'll really mix it up. He will insult people personally. And, you know, he does not seem now to be shrinking away from the camera. So, I mean, I don't know if this is going to cost them seats, but
you're
I do
laughing.
Think you're,
you're laughing,
that.
Ben. You're younger than me. Do you think this is something that anybody normal would enjoy being what he is now? This is not a bonfire of the vanities, this thing.
He's got to not be having fun. I mean, his wife is a very private person, a kind of keeper of Clinton's secrets. I think that's the other pole of this. He's a very public person, but he also is connected to Clinton land, where this sort of thing is not welcome.